The virtual ground is a concept that plays an important role in solving any numerical problem based on operational amplifier. In this video of electronics, we will understand the virtual ground concept for operational amplifier and also understand that this concept cannot be used under various conditions. To understand the virtual ground concept, first let's understand an operational amplifier. An operational amplifier has two types of voltage gain. If the input of an operational amplifier is not feedback from the output, it is called open loop operational amplifier, whose voltage gain is called open loop voltage gain. This is the ratio of the output voltage and the difference of the input voltage, which is the difference of non-inverting terminal voltage and the inverting terminal voltage. It is also called internal voltage gain. If the input terminal of the operational amplifier is feedbacked with the output, it is called closed loop operational amplifier. Such an operational amplifier has two types of gain. An open loop gain, which is the ratio of the output voltage and the difference between internal input voltage. The second, closed loop gain, which is the ratio of the output and the difference between applied or external voltage. The open loop voltage gain of an ideal operational amplifier is infinite. Open loop voltage gain may be infinite if either the output voltage is infinite or the difference voltage of operational amplifier is zero. The output voltage of an operational amplifier cannot be infinite because of its plus VCC and minus VEE terminals. Both these terminals are installed so that the operational amplifier can work in this voltage range only. Due to these terminals, the output voltage of the operational amplifier is never exceed plus VCC and minus VEE values. Or you can say that the maximum or minimum output voltage of an operational amplifier only plus VCC or minus VEE volt can be possible. So, since the output voltage is not possible to be infinite, therefore, for the gain to be infinite, the difference voltage must be zero. This means that the internal non-inverting and inverting terminals of the operational amplifier should be at the same potential, whose difference should be equal to zero. Any terminal can be on the same potential only if both the terminals are directly connected to each other. In this way, both internal inverting and non-inverting terminals of an operational amplifier are also considered to be connected to each other. But this connection is not real, but is considered virtually connected. This concept is called the virtual ground concept. According to this, internal inverting and non-inverting terminal of an ideal operational amplifier will be at the same potential. Now let's talk about how this concept can be used in numerical problems. Let's consider a circuit diagram for this. It has input voltage applied to the inverting terminal, so it is an inverting operational amplifier. The non-inverting terminal is grounded and given operational amplifier is ideal, means open loop voltage gain will be infinite. Since the non-inverting terminal is grounded, the node point A from the virtual ground concept should also be grounded, which is at zero potential. Now if Kirchhoff's node analysis is used at node point A, current I1 will be equal to the current I2, because the input impedance of the ideal operational amplifier is infinite, so the current goes directly to the feedback resistance at the node point. With the node analysis, current I1 will have values 10⁻⁰/100k and current I2 will have values 0⁻⁰/500k. Solving this brings the output voltage to -50V. One thing to be observed here is that the open loop gain of an ideal operational amplifier is infinite, but the closed loop gain is 5. In this way, the virtual ground concept is very helpful in solving the numerical problems of an ideal operational amplifier. But this concept does not apply to all types of operational amplifier. It has some limitations. The first limitation is that the virtual ground concept only applies to the internal terminals of the op-amp, not to the external terminals. This is an inverting operational amplifier whose open loop gain is infinite. Node point A is its internal input and V volt is its external input. So from the virtual ground concept, the voltage of node point A will be equal to the non-inverting voltage 0, but not external input voltage. The virtual ground concept can never be used at the applied voltage. Second limitation is that The virtual ground concept is applicable only for ideal operational amplifier. If the operational amplifier is practical, then the virtual ground concept will not be applicable. The open loop gain of an ideal operational amplifier is infinite, while for practical operational amplifier, open loop gain is finite. There is a problem that how to solve the question without using virtual ground concept. Let's understand this by example. The example has two operational amplifier given. One is ideal and the other is practical, whose open loop gain is 10. First, let's calculate the output voltage for the ideal operational amplifier. So the voltage at node point A from the virtual ground concept will be 0, and by node analysis, current I1 will be equal to current I2. Current I1 will be equal to 10 minus 0 upon 100k, and I2 will be equal to 0 minus V0 upon 500k. Solving this brings the output voltage to minus 50 volt and closed loop gain 5. Now let's solve practical operational amplifier. Since the operational amplifier is practical, we cannot use virtual ground concept. But in this question, open loop gain is given 10, and assume that the voltage at the node point A is V. Then from the formula of open loop gain, calculate the voltage of node point A in terms of output voltage. With the help of node analysis, I1 will be equal to I2. When calculating the values of I1 and I2, the output voltage comes in terms of V. Replacing it with the equation 1 gives us the value of output voltage minus 41.6 volt and closed loop gain is 4.1. Comparing both operational amplifier, it is found that practical operational amplifier voltage gain is less than that of the ideal operational amplifier. As the open loop gain of the practical operational amplifier increases, the difference decreases. And the practical operational amplifier also behaves like an ideal operational amplifier at much higher values of the open loop gain. The third limitation is that the virtual ground concept is applicable only for closed loop operational amplifier, not for open loop operational amplifier. This is the ideal open loop operational amplifier. The input voltage of 10 volt has been applied on the inverting terminal. Now, since there is no feedback resistance, the same voltage will also be on the internal terminal of this operational amplifier. If in this case we will use the virtual ground concept, then 10 volt has to be equal to 0, which is not possible. This is why virtual ground concept is not applicable for our open loop operational amplifier. If we talk about the output of this operational amplifier, then on using the open loop gain formula, the output voltage should be minus infinite. But due to minus VEE terminals, output cannot exceed beyond minus VEE volt. Fourth limitation is the virtual ground concept will be applicable only for negative feedback operational amplifier, not for positive feedback operational amplifier. Positive feedback operational amplifier are operational amplifier whose non-inverting terminal is fed with output. The virtual ground concept cannot be used for such an operational amplifier. Fifth limitation is that even if the operational amplifier is a closed loop ideal operational amplifier with negative feedback, the virtual ground concept will not be applicable if the voltage of both internal terminals of the op-amp is given. To be applicable to the virtual ground concept, it is necessary that the voltage of any one terminal of both the internal terminals is given. If the voltage of both terminals are given, then we cannot equal it by force using virtual ground concept. In this way, to use the virtual ground concept, it is necessary that the operational amplifier is ideal, in closed loop, in negative feedback, and given the value of any one internal terminal voltage.